Boris Jixie here. Hi for you, and welcome to an Enten Jixie Diary. Today I wanted to jump on the bandwagon a bit, I suppose. It's, you know, kind of about time for me to do a little something where I talk about what everybody in the world is basically talking about and thinking about and, you know, writing about and whatever, which is coronavirus. So a few days ago, I received a letter from number 10 Downing Street, which is the home of our British Prime Minister, which talks about in depth about coronavirus and has instructions for kind of what to do about this, you know, how we should behave, I suppose, as British people. How we should behave. Not all of you are British, I know. So I wanted to read this letter out and the leaflet that goes along with it, not just because I feel that there's so much misinformation going around, and at least you know that this is what is actually, if you can see, it's actually got, you know, the government sort of official seal on there. You know, it's... You know that this is accurate information as we are receiving it, the British people are receiving it. But not only for that reason, just for its authenticity, so you know, because there is a lot of misinformation going around, especially on Facebook and Twitter, you know, and I wanted to make sure that you guys had the actual information, at least according to the British government. Not only that, but I also know a lot of visually impaired people like myself, you know, have received these letters, and not everyone is as lucky as me in that they can actually read it. So, for those of you who are visually impaired, who may have received this letter and don't have, like, PAs or carers like me that can read it to you, I mean, I don't need it, obviously, because I can read it. It's just big enough that I can read it. But, you know, for those who don't have carers or parents or family of any kind that can read it, here it is, basically. I'm not sure how legal this is. Please, if it's not legal to read it, please, government, don't arrest me. I'm just trying to sort of perform a bit of a service here. And I would much prefer you just tell me to take it down rather than arrest me, please. Thank you. If it is legal, then I'm glad, and I hope that you get something out of listening to this. I will read the entirety of the leaflet, even bits that are not relevant to me, simply because it might be relevant to others. Before I do read that, though, I want to talk about a little bit about a video that came up in my recommended on YouTube, which was Boris Johnson talking about how he, you know, about the care that he's received from the NHS and how grateful he was, and how he praises the NHS and requests and kind of advises that we look after the NHS. The NHS obviously is a British thing, which is the National Health Service, which is paid for by our taxes, rather than, I know that in America and some other countries you guys have insurance and don't have a National Health Service like we do. And obviously it's important to support your own nurses and doctors in your own countries. However, you know, Boris Johnson talks about the NHS and the care that he received, and you could tell from the video, and I'll link it down below, you could tell from, you know, the way that he spoke, he's still very short of breath, he's still definitely getting over the coronavirus. A lot of people have criticized him for naming doctors and nurses by name, and, you know, and kind of, I suppose, I don't know what the word is. I think that, you know, many people think that, you know, Boris Johnson wouldn't have received the care that, you know, as devoted a care as he did receive if he wasn't the Prime Minister. And that may or may not be true. I don't know. But, you know, they kind of criticised him for kind of making light of the fact, I suppose, that he received more care than most people would do, you know, than the everyday bog standard, you know, the, you know, person on the street would receive if they, had coronavirus. But, you know, I think that it's important to kind of thank the people in, you know, even though he may have received more care. We don't know. We can't judge. But I think it's still important that, he thanked those people, for the care that they received, for the care that he received. But yeah, a lot of people have, some people, really unfeeling people, have kind of said that it's his comeuppance that he received, that he contracted coronavirus, because he didn't kind of lock us down sooner than he did, and he didn't take it as seriously as he could have done. And, you know, that may or may not be true as well. But I've never wished him badly. I've never wished bad things on him just because of how he dealt with things. We all do what we think is the right thing at the time. And I'm sure that he didn't have any malice towards the British public and it is in his best interest to take care of the British public. So I can't imagine that he would have had some sort of evil designs on the British public. So I feel it's a bit uncalled for to kind of laugh about the fact that he's got coronavirus. Like, oh my God, he's got coronavirus. Well, now we'll see, won't he? I don't wish this on anyone. It's horrible. It's horrible that it's reached every part of the world and that it's impacted the world that in the way that it has. It's, the most kind of, it's something that has gripped the world, in such a strong way. And people are likening, coronavirus to the world wars in the size of the impact that it's made on the world. And it will continue to make an impact. What that impact will be is not for us to know right now. But I really hope that this experience teaches us to stop taking things for granted, like being able to walk down the street, like, our neighbours and, colleagues and people that we wouldn't ordinarily get to know that now we do know. I really hope that all of my subscribers out there are staying safe, staying at home, and, I really hope that we can weather this without losing too many more, any more people, but I suppose that's not realistic. I hope that people staying at home will flatten the curve, and I just hope that we can get through this. My opinion on this whole coronavirus has differed, has kind of ranged from sort of thinking, oh, it'll be over in a few months, to thinking, oh God, this is the end of humanity. But, whatever this is, I really hope that we come out of this being a lot kinder towards each other and taking a lot less for granted than we have done. And so, without further ado, I shall read this letter now and the subsequent leaflet that goes with it. I hope that this is useful to you. And, from the Prime Minister. I am writing to you to update you on the steps we are taking to combat coronavirus. In just a few short weeks, everyday life in this country has changed dramatically. We all feel the profound impact of coronavirus, not just on ourselves, but on our loved ones and our communities. I understand completely the difficulties this disruption has caused to your lives, businesses, and jobs. But the action we have taken is absolutely necessary. For one very simple reason. If too many people become seriously unwell at one time, the NHS will be unable to cope. This will cost lives. We must slow the spread of the disease and reduce the number of people needing hospital treatment in order to save as many lives as possible. That is why we are giving one simple instruction. You must stay at home. You should not meet friends or relatives who do not live in your home. You may only leave your home for very limited purposes, such as buying food and medicine, exercising once a day, and seeking medical attention. You can travel to and from work, but should work from home if you can. When you do have to leave your home, you should ensure, wherever possible, that you are 2 meters apart from anyone outside of your household. These rules must be observed, so if people break the rules, the police will issue fines and disperse gatherings. I know many of you will be deeply worried about the financial impact on you and your family. The government will do whatever it takes to help you make ends meet and put food on the table. The enclosed leaflet sets out more detail about the support available and the rules you need to follow. You can also find the latest advice on at gov.uk/coronavirus. From the start, we have sought to put in the right measures at the right time. We will not hesitate to go further if that is what the scientific and medical advice tells us we must do. It is important for me to level with you. We know things will get worse before they get better, but we are making the right preparations, and the more we all follow the rules, the fewer lives will be lost and the sooner life can return to normal. We want to thank everyone who is working flat out to beat the virus, in particular the staff at our fantastic NHS and care sector across England, Scotland, Wales and Northern Ireland. It has been truly inspirational to see our doctors, nurses and other carers rise magnificently to the needs of the hour. Thousands of retired doctors and nurses are returning to the NHS, and hundreds and thousands of citizens are volunteering to help the most vulnerable. It is with that great British spirit that we will beat coronavirus, and we will beat it together. That is why, at this moment of national emergency, I urge you, please, to stay at home, protect the NHS, and save lives. Boris Johnson. Woo! Got all emotional there. Wow. Because I used to not be proud of being British. I used to think that we had kind of a bit of a rubbish culture. And that, you know, our culture is such a hodgepodge of other cultures. You know, we were invaded by so many different people, by Vikings and Normans and Romans and all of these things. And we don't really have that much of a culture. And even our national dish is a dish from another culture, which is, you know, tikka tikka masala, which is a curry. You know, I used to think we don't have that much of a culture. And, you know, we've got a rubbish football team and, you know, we rubbish at cricket and, you know, I used to just sort of think, oh God. And Eurovision, we always come last in Eurovision, which I love Eurovision. I am such a Eurovision hound. I am crazy about that. I love Eurovision. And unfortunately, I think it's going to be cancelled this year, which I'm so gutted about. Despite that, I'm trying to keep my spirits up, even though my favourite thing of the year, the thing that I look forward to, well, the third thing that I look forward to most in the year, after Christmas and Bonfire Night, it's my favourite, one of my favourite things of the year, and it's been cancelled, and I'm trying to keep my spirits up, but we've always, you know, had kind of, we've always been a bit rubbish, really, Britain, and I've never really kind of, I always wanted to, you know, oh, I'd love to, you know, not be English, instead be like Spanish or Swedish or Danish, or, you know, especially now, as you know, that I'm learning Danish. You know, I love learning other languages, I love learning about other cultures, and I always used to think that other cultures had so much more to them than the British culture. And, you know, while that's true in some ways, it's also not true, because it's recently that I've realised that Britain has a culture. It may not be, you know, as distinct as some other cultures, but we have been invaded by all these things. We have been invaded by Normans and Romans and Vikings and, you know, various other things. You know, we have. And the thing is, and the thing that I really need to respect more, is that we've survived all of those things and come out stronger as a result. And so, you know, this may impact us. Coronavirus may impact us. It may impact the world. It will impact the world. It has impacted the world. But, you know, I feel like at least Britain will come out of this stronger and more together. And we will beat it. It may take a while, but I feel like if people play by the rules, stay inside, look after those that are more vulnerable, you know, I'm immunocompromised, but I'm not, you know, I have, it, my condition is complicated, and I will talk to you more about my condition, but I think I already did do a video on it, but I've not talked fully about it, and I do want to do that at some point. Anyway, but I'm not as bad as some people. Like, some people have no immune system at all. And I feel like it's important to look after those people. And, you know, to look after the people that, you know, we may not know, but the people that we know them. And you know, so the ripple effect can be felt. Even though we may not know someone that has coronavirus, we may not. But someone that we might know somebody, or someone that they know might know somebody. And the ripple effect can be felt. And what hurts one person should hurt us all, and does hurt us all. And I feel like we need to suck it up, deal with the lockdown, even though, you know, we have low spirits sometimes because of this. And, you know, but stay strong and stay through this together. I do intend to, because one of the things that we do here in England is called the Clap for Carers. And it's something that we do every Thursday night at 8 p.m. And it's where we stand on our front doorsteps and we clap for the NHS, for care staff, for supermarket staff, for the people that keep this country going when, you know, we are at our lowest. And, you know, without them, we wouldn't be anything. You know, and in a way, this does liken us to the world wars, in that, yes, you know, we may be just, you know, we're not being bombed, but there is, you know, there are people risking their lives daily for our health, for our safety. You know, people like my mum, for example, who I love so much, who goes to work. She's a nurse in A&E, dealing with people with coronavirus. I hope she won't mind me saying this. She deals with people with coronavirus every day, and I worry about her so much. I would be devastated if anything happened to her. I love her, and I'm so proud of how brave she is going into work day after day, and all the other people that like her that do that, including my carer, my PA, who I won't name because she won't want me to, but, you know, she comes to work to see me day after day. Well, not day after day, she comes to see me 3 times a week, but she does it, and she has such courage, as do the supermarket staff, as do food workers who work in factories, people that keep us going so that we can get through this. And I'm so proud of those people. And it's those people who we need to thank. So I clap. I you know, I actually didn't. I missed it last week. I fell asleep. But I, you know, I will be there on Thursday. I'm planning on filming that so that you guys who don't do this in different countries will see it. And maybe you guys can start this in your own countries. Because I think it's really important at this time to really recognize the people that, you know, kind of haven't always been in the spotlight, don't always make the most money, don't always get the most kind of, you know, recognition, but are there risking their lives and having courage day after day to do what they do. That was a long speech. I'm sorry, guys. I will get to the leaflet now. So this is coronavirus. Stay at home. Protect the NHS. Save lives. So I'll read all of this. It's long, but I think that we all need to know it. Well, I know that you guys, you know, that's why I'm here. Right, so, stay at home. The single most important action you can take is to stay at home in order to protect the NHS and save lives. You should only leave the house for very limited reasons. Shopping for basic necessities, for example food and medicine, as infrequently as possible. One form of exercise a day, for example a run, walk or cycle, alone or with members of your household. Any medical need, including to donate blood, avoid risk of harm, provide care, or help a vulnerable person. traveling for work purposes, but only where you cannot work from home. These are exceptions. And when doing these activities, you should minimize time spent outside of the home and ensure you are 2 meters apart from anyone outside of your household. Critical workers and parents of vulnerable children may leave the house to take their children to and from school or their childcare provider. More detail is available online. Children can be moved between homes if their parents live separately. Symptoms. You may have coronavirus if you have either of the following symptoms, however mild: a high temperature, a new continuous cough. Anyone who has these symptoms must stay at home until the symptoms have ended, and in all cases for at least 7 days. Everyone else in the household must stay at home for at least 14 days after the first person's symptoms appear, even if they themselves do not have symptoms. If anyone else develops symptoms during that time, the individual must stay home for an additional 7 days from when they developed symptoms. Once 7 days have passed and provided symptoms have ended, they no longer need to isolate. Do not go to a GP surgery, pharmacy or hospital. Use NHS online services. Only call 111 if you are not able to get online, you have been instructed to call, or your symptoms worsen. Call 999, which is our emergency number here in Britain, if you have a serious or life-threatening emergency, and tell the call advisor if you have coronavirus symptoms. Advice for those who are 70 or older, have an underlying health condition, or are pregnant. People who are 70 and over, or those who have an underlying health condition, are likely to be more seriously affected. It is even more important that you protect yourself now by following the advice above. If you are at very high risk due to a serious underlying health condition, you should have already received a letter from the NHS containing specific guidelines about what to do. If you need shopping or medication, ask family, friends or neighbours to drop these at the door, or if possible, order online. Use NHS online services or the NHS app to book appointments or order repeat prescriptions. Only phone if this is not possible. GP consultation should be done over the phone or online to minimise risk to you and the other patients. GP practices may postpone non-urgent health checks or routine appointments. There is helpful information and advice for pregnant women about coronavirus on the Royal College of Obstetricians and Gynecologists website. Support for businesses and workers. The government knows that all of these measures have a huge impact on businesses, households, and people across the country, and has taken action to protect lives and incomes for businesses. More than $330 billion is being made available in loans and guarantees. Another $20 billion is being given to businesses through tax relief and cash grants. HMRC is deferring VAT payments for the next quarter for workers and families. The coronavirus job retention scheme means employees can receive 80% of their wages up to a maximum of $2,500 per month. The coronavirus self-employment income support scheme will provide a grant to most self-employed individuals or partnerships worth 80% of their profits, up to a cap of $2,500 per month. Extra support for the unemployed and those on low incomes through universal credit and tax credits worth up to £1,040. Nearly $1 billion of additional support for renters, mortgage holidays of 3 months for anyone in difficulty due to coronavirus, including owners of buy-to-let properties. This is just some of the support available for businesses and workers. Further information is available online. I know that won't be relevant to most of you guys, but I want to read it for the people that it would be relevant for. Help stop. This is, actually, I should probably kind of show you this. It's a little kind of flowchart thing about how you should stay at home and who should stay at home and how long for. So pause this if you want to read this properly. It's kind of hard for me to explain just by reading it. So, yeah, sorry. Help stop the infection spreading and support each other. Wash your hands with soap and water often. Do this for at least 20 seconds. Some people do the whole happy birthday song thing. Cover your mouth and nose with a tissue or your sleeve, not your hands when you cough or sneeze. So you can do it into your elbow like that. Some people do that. And, you know, yeah, just don't do it in your hands. Use tissues in the bin immediately and wash your hands afterwards. Don't touch your eyes, nose or mouth if your hands are not clean. Clean and disinfect frequently touched surfaces and objects in your home, such as door handles and taps. Shop responsibly. Follow advice in stores and only buy what you need for yourself and your family and those you're supporting. And then it has a handy little diagram here about how to wash your hands. But there is lots of advice and how-to about this on YouTube. So that's, you know, by the way. And then going to work. So this is for carers, like my lovely carers, Sarah and unnamed carer that I can't mention. Going to work. You may travel for work purposes, but only where you cannot work from home. Employers and employees should discuss their working arrangements, and employees should take every possible step to facilitate their employees working from home. Certain jobs require people to travel to the place of work. If you cannot work from home, then you can still travel to work, provided neither you nor any of your household have coronavirus symptoms. This is consistent with advice from the chief medical officer. Further information on all of these areas and more is available online. 1. Stay at home, protect the NHS, save lives. And that's basically the whole entire leaflet. So I just, again, want to finish by saying, just to reiterate and not to go on for ages about it, that I just really wanted to provide correct and up-to-the-date information as we have it here in Britain. But it's important to follow your own country's advice, because they will know better about how the land lies in your specific country. This is just the information we're getting, and so if you haven't received anything like this in your own country, then you at least know this is like the sort of the least amount of information that you must at least do this information, if nothing else, to stay safe, to protect others who are less who are more vulnerable than you. So hopefully we can flatten the curve. Hopefully we'll come out of all of this, and hopefully, touch wood, the next Jixie diary that you see will be me outside having fun doing things, and this all will be over soon. I don't see that will be likely. When this all is over, I actually do have a few videos planned for you that I think that you will enjoy. A few of them are disability related, but also I want to do a few other little like out and about things, because summer is, you know, on its way, and we don't want to be stuck inside while it's beautiful and sunny outside. So hopefully all of this will be over, this craziness will be over, but it can only be over as soon as possible if people actually kind of stick by the rules and, you know, kind of protect the NHS if you're in England, protect your own health services if you're in different countries, and protect each other. So I'm gonna go and stay safe, guys. I love you. Hopefully this will be all over soon. Thank you so much to my new subscribers that I have received, and thank you if you're new here. Thank you for watching this video. And please like, because it helps my channel grow, and subscribe, and thank you very much. Peace.
'll meet again, don't know where, don't know when, but I know we'll meet again some sunny day. just like you always do, till the blue skies drive the dark clouds far away.